فؤادك الأيام فتى.
اللوح المحفوظ is written for him. All of it happens with his mashi'ah, his will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all of it Allah created. Allah created it, subhanahu. He created it. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's qadr, in terms of its knowledge and in terms of its writings, is of four types. Write this down, it helps you a lot to understand. The qadr, when the scholars of Ahlul Sunnah, they explained it, they put it down in these four types, but in terms of knowledge and in terms of its writings. And it makes you understand a lot of issues. First of all is what? The first one is called Al-Qadr Al-Azaliyu. Al-Qadr Al-Azaliyu means what? The Qadr which is written on the Lawh Al-Mahfuz. That type is called Qadr Al-Azali. It's never altered. It's never changed. It's written in the Lawh Al-Mahfuz. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has written that. You see? Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. He has destined that one. He has written it. No one can change that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the one is written on the Lawh Al-Mahfuz. It's the one in Surah Al-Qamar, ayah 49. Inna kulla shay'in khalaqnahu biqadar. The second one is Al-Qadr Al-Umri. This one is the lifespan of the creation. Or it's a yearly one. It's Umr, just a person, the yearly cycle that a person does. Or a person's lifespan, 60 years that this person is going to be. Allah destines that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the one in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. The hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ يُجْمَعُ خَلْقُهُ فِي بَطْنِ أُمِّهِ 40 يَوْمًا نُطْفَةً ثُمَّ يَكُونُ عَلَقَةً مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ ثُمَّ يَكُونُ مُضْغَةً مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ ثُمَّ يُرْسَلُ إِلَيْهِ الْمَلَكُ فَيُنْفَخُ فِيهِ الرُّوحُ وَيُؤْمَرُ بِأَرْبَعِ كَلِمَاتٍ بِكَتْبِ رِزْقِهِ وَأَجَلِهِ وَعَمَلِهِ وَشَقِيٌّ أَوْ سَعِيدٌ. The angels right now writing again. What writing is he doing? The writing here that he's writing is called Umri, it's the person's life. Already there's one written in the Lawh Al-Mahfuz, that's called the Azali one. The angel now is coming down, is called Qad, he's writing what? The Qadr, he's writing the Umri one. There's another one called the Hawliyu. The Hawli one is the one that takes place on Laylatul Qadr. It takes when? Laylatul Qadr. It happens in what? Laylatul Qadr. It's the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Surah Al-Dukhan, ayah 3 and ayah 4, inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakatin, inna kunna mundirin, fiha, in that night, yufraqu. It's, Allah breaks down, it breaks down, kullu amrin hakim. Every matter is broken down that day. Laylatul Qadr. And the fourth one is Al-Qadr Al-Yawmi. There's a daily one. It's a daily one. It's specific to that day only. And it's the one Allah said in Surah Al-Rahman, ayah 29, كُلَّ يَوْمٍ هُوَ فِي شَأْنٍ. Every day the person is upon a affair. The angels write that down. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى. Allah also says, إِنَّا كُنَّا نَسْتَنْسِخُ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. We also used to write that which you guys were upon daily. Daily, it was written for you guys. Daily. نعم. So that is matters pertaining to Al-Qadr. And that's how it's written, and that's how it is in terms of knowledge. Na'am.
وَأَنَّ الْجَهْمِيَّةَ كُفَّارِ.
The Jahmiyyah are kuffar. Na'am. The Jahmiyyah are who? The Jahmiyyah are kuffar. That they are who? They are kuffar. A lot of scholars took that view. That Jahmiyyah are kuffar. And a lot of them, they consider them to be from what? Some of them, they consider them what? To be from the Muslims. Some said that. Like in the majority, a lot of the scholars believe that they're kuffar, the statements that they said. That they are what? Kuffar. And Imam al-Bahari, rahimahullah, in Sharh al-Sunnah, he said, وَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ إِنَّمَا جَاءَ هَلَاكُ الْجَهْمِيَّةِ. وَعْلَمْ نَوْ إِنَّمَا جَاءَ هَلَاكُ الْجَهْمِيَّةِ. That the destruction of the Jahmiyyah had come. أَنَّهُمْ فَكَّرُوا فِي الرَّبِّ. Their destruction came because they thought about Allah. فَأَدْقَلُوا. And they started to enter into their vocabulary by saying, لِمَا how, وَكَيْفَ how. وَتَرَكُوا الْأَثَرَ. And they left a text. وَوَضَعُوا الْقِيَاسَ. And they placed for themselves analogy. وَقَاسُوا الدِّينَ عَلَى رَأِيهِمْ. And they started to scale the religion on their logic. فَجَاءُوا بِالْكُفْرِ. And they came with disbelief. عَيَانًا individually. لَا يَخْفَى. It is not hidden. فَكَفَّرُوا. They became kuffar. وَكَفَّرَ الْخَلْقَ. And فَكَفَّرُوا. They became kuffar. فَكَفَّرُوا الْخَلْقَ وَضَّرَّهُمُ الْأَمْرُ إِلَىٰ أَنْ قَالُوا بِالتَّعْطِيلِ. They disbelieved the creation and it necessitate that they went to ta'til. It is a very long statement of his. If you go to it, you will benefit in his kitab Sharh al-Sunnah. So kuffar, that they Jahmiyyah are because of the statement which they have said and the kufr which they believe. And we mentioned some of it at the beginning of the book. Na'am.
وَأَنَّ الرَّافِضَةَ رَفَضُوا الْإِسْلَامِ.
And that the Rafidah, and they are the who are the Rafida? they're the ones who insult the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first person who ever called them Rafida was Zayd ibn Ali. When he went to Kufa and they went with him, he asked him about Abu Bakr. And then Umar, they asked him about Abu Bakr and Umar. They asked him about Abu Bakr and Umar and he praised him with good. He praised Abu Bakr and Umar with good. And then they left him. They left him. فقال, he then said to them, رفضتموني, you guys have refused me. That's what he said to them. So from then onwards, they were called Rafidatu. From that minute onwards, they were called what? Rafida. Naam. So the Rafida, they refused Islam. Meaning they refused the correct understanding of Islam. Naam. And from within the Rafida, are those who are kuffar, like the Nusayriya, who call themselves Alawis. They're nothing to do with Ali ibn Abi Talib. They are kuffar, Nusayriya, Bashar, Asad, Al-Hafidh al-Asad, and that family. They're kuffar, they're not Muslimin. لا من قريب ولا من بعيد. They're kuffar. They are what? They're kuffar. The ones that run Surya are what? Kuffar. Why? They believe Ali is an ilah. They believe Ali, they give Ali uluhiyya, they worship Ali ibn Abi Talib. So they are what? They are kuffar. Naam. Ithna Ashariya are kuffar. The Ithna Ashariya are what? The Iran and their dynasty, they are what? Kuffar. Naam. Naam.
Wal Khawariju Murraq.
The Khawarij are what? Murraq. Murraq means what? Those who have exited. The Khawarij are what? Those who are murraqun, they exited. Ay maraqu anil islami, they exited Islam. They exited Islam. And based on that, some of the salaf of this ummah, they done takfir on them. Some scholars have made takfir on them based on the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he said, يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ الدِّينِ كَمَا يَمْرُقُ السَّهْمُ مِنَ الرَّمِيَّةِ. That they exit Islam the way the arrow exits the bow. So they done takfir on them like that. But the strongest, inshallah ta'ala, is that they are not kuffar. Because Ali ibn Abi Talib, when he was asked about the Khawarij, they said, أَهُمْ كُفَّارٌ. Are they kuffar? And Ali ibn Abi Talib looked and he said, مِنَ الْكُفْرِ فَرُّ. They ran away from kufr. The Khawarij are running away from kufr. And then he said, هُمْ إِخْوَانُنَا. They are our brothers. بَغَوْ عَلَيْنَا. They have transgressed on us. They are our brothers who have transgressed on us. Naam. So the word murraq means what? It's the plural of the word mariq. And the mariq is what? The mariq is, هو الذي يدخل في شيء ويخرج. It's the one who enters into something and then he comes out of it. That's what it means. That's what they mean. And that he got that from where? He got that from the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The hadith that are pertaining to the Khawarij are mutawatir. بلغوا. It has reached حد التواتر. It's reached multitude narrations. The hadith that have come regarding the Khawarij.
ومن زعم أن القرآن مخلوق فهو كافر بالله العظيم كفرا ينقل عن الملة ومن شك في كفره ممن يفهم فهو كافر.
دائمة السلف, they've all stated, or the majority of them have stated, that anyone who says that the Qur'an is makhluq, it's created, he's a kafir. He's a disbeliever. He's a kafir. And the kufr that is intended here, the author has mentioned it to you, which is kufrun yukhriju min al-millah. It's a kufr that will take the person out of Islam, out of the religion. Why? Because he disbelieves in the verse of Allah. What verse is it? وَإِنْ أَحَدُ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرُ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ. The ayahs that show all of this. Or the ayah that was in Surah At-Tawbah, Ayah 6, or the one in Surah Al-Kahf, Ayah 109, where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said, قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتَ رَبِّي لَنَفِدَ الْبَحْرُ قَبْلَ أَن تَنْفَدَ كَلِمَاتُ رَبِّي وَلَوْ جِئْنَا بِمِثْلِهِ مَدَدًا. So it's a disbelief of the Qur'an. لأنه كذب الله في قوله في خبره حيث إن الله أخبر أن القرآن كلامه في آيات كثيرة. So he's disbelieved in those verses. So the author then goes on, وَمَنْ شَكَّ فِي كُفْرِهِ. Anybody who doubts the kufr of that person, مِمَّنْ يَفْهَمُ. Not everybody, but the one who knows that this issue, who doubts it then he said, فَوَا كَافِرٌ. He is a kafir himself. نعم.
Nah. ومن شك في كلام الله عز وجل فوقف شاكا فيه يقول لا أدري مخلوق أو غير مخلوق فهو جهمي ومن وقف في القرآن جاهلا علم وبدع ولم يكفر ومن قال لفظي بالقرآن مخلوق فهو جهمي أو القرآن بلفظي مخلوق فهو جهمي.
It is not permissible for a person to say that my wording in which I'm reading the Quran with is created. Why? Because this issue has a resemblance. There's a possibility you could mean that my voice is created. Na'am, your voice is created. And your actions are created by Allah. But there's that possibility of you trying to also say that the Quran is created. And so the matter being muhtamal, mean each of any one of them, the Salaf were very serious on this issue. They were serious on this issue. And this is what the author said. وَمَنْ شَكَّ فِي كَلَامِ اللَّهِ So he categorized the people. He categorized the people when it comes to the issue of is the Quran created? And he put them into categories. The first ones are those who say that the Quran is makhluq. There are those who are explicit in it. They're the first group. They said that the Quran is created. And they're like the Mu'tazila. The Mu'tazila, who has said this statement, which is shani'. That the Quran is what? It's makhluq. The second group are those who said, lafzuna bil Quran makhluq. Our wordings in the Quran is created. The Salaf also considered those ones to be mubtadi'ah, innovators. The Salaf did. The third group are those who said what? The third groups are those who said makhluqun wala ghayra makhluqin. They said la naqulu, we will not say it's created and we won't say it's not created. They're the ones who called that waqifa. They withhold from it. And these are worse than the ones who said that the Quran is created. They're worse than the ones who said it's created. So it's very serious when it comes to the Quran being created. Na'am. That person who doesn't know it, who withholds from it, he will be educated. If he still remains on it, buddi'ah, he's an innovator. He's an innovator and he's not considered from Ahlul Sunnah. Imam Muhammad ibn Hanbal, he said in his Usul Sunnah, وَالْقُرْآنُ كَلَامُ اللَّهِ The Quran is the speech of Allah. وَلَيْسَ بِمَخْلُوقٍ And it's not created. وَلَا يَضْعُفُ أَنْ يَقُولَ لَيْسَ بِمَخْلُوقٍ أو فَإِنَّ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ لَيْسَ بِبَائِنٍ مِّنْهُ وَلَيْسَ مِنْهُ شَيْءٌ مَخْلُوقٌ وَإِيَّاكَ وَمُنَاظَرَةِ مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِيهِ وَمَنْ قَالَ بِاللَّفْظِ وَغَيْرِهِ وَمَنْ وَقَفَ فِيهِ فَقَالَ لَا أَدْرِي مَخْلُوقٌ أَوْ لَيْسَ بِمَخْلُوقٍ وإنما هو كلام الله فهذا صاحب بدعة مثل من قال هو مخلوق وإنما هو كلام الله ليس بمخلوق. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal refutes those groups that we've mentioned, those who say that the Quran is created, those who've said that my wording of the recitation of the Quran is created. And the third group who said I'm not going to say it's مخلوق and I'm not going to say it's not مخلوق. All of those Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal he refuted them. نعم in his Usul Sunnah.
قال أبو محمد وسمعت أبي يقول وعلامة أهل البدعة الوقيعة في أهل الأثر
وعلامة
أهل البدعة الوقيعة في أهل الأثر
أبو محمد which is the son of أبو حاتم الرازي Abu Muhammad Abd al-Rahman ibn Abi Hatim, he said, I heard my father, meaning Abi Hatim al-Razi, saying, وَعَلَامَةُ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ How can one recognize an innovator? The way to recognize an innovator is, الْوَقِيعَةُ فِي أَهْلِ الْأَثَرِ They slander the people of the text. أَهْلُ الْأَثَرِ are those who follow the Kitab and the Sunnah. أَهْلُ الْأَثَرِ are those who are what? أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ They have many names. أَهْلُ الْأَثَرِ أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ سَلَفِيُّونَ أَهْلُ الْحَدِيثِ and other names. Na'am. They criticize them and they critique them. Na'am.
وَعَلَامَةُ الزَّنَادِقَةِ تَسْمِيَتُهُمْ أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ حَشَوِيَّةِ يُرِيدُونَ إِبْطَالَ الْأَثَارِ قال وعلامة الجهمية تسميتهم أهل السنة مشبهة. قال وعلامة القدرية تسميتهم أهل الأثر مجبرة. وعلامة المرجئة تسميتهم أهل السنة مخالفة وتقصانية
ونقصانية
ونقصانية. وعلامة الرافضة تسميتهم أهل السنة ناصبة.
The علامات of أهل البدع, these are groups. He's specifically mentioning فرق الضالة, misguided groups, names that they've given to أهل الأثر, أهل السنة. He said علامة الزنادقة. A zandiq is a person who shows Islam and he has kufr in his heart. What do they do? تسمية أهل السنة, they call أهل السنة حشوية. حشوية is anyone who has no خير in him. وهو ما لا خير فيه. It's the waste and the leftovers. Those like nothing, that's something that's no خير in it. They call أهل السنة this. Why do they say that? يريدون إبطال الآثار. The reason by calling أهل السنة حشوية is that they want to nullify the text that they're bringing forward. So this is the tactic of Iblis عليه لعائنullah before and also the people of innovation is because they want to put down what the person is carrying and what the person has with him. They first of all attack the person. You see the Rafida, they don't just want Abu Bakr, they don't just want Umar, they don't just want Abu Huraira, but they want to nullify what they're carrying. When Abu Huraira goes and they get that argument across that Abu Huraira is a liar, you see, automatically what will happen? All the narrations that we have will go. So what do these people want? They will want our witnesses. Naam. And we're going to see that statement inshaAllah ta'ala. So this is the alamatu zanadiqa. You see, it's alama, a sign known for a zindiq who criticized the people of the sunnah. Wa alamatu al-jahmiya. The jahmiya, the way they recognize is that they call ahlu sunnah mushabbiha. Anthropomorphism. They say this is what they call ahlu sunnah. They say Ahlul Sunnah are those who make Allah's characteristics same to. These are who? The Jahmiyyah do this. Alama Jahmiyyin. This is a sign that when you see a person calling Ahlul Sunnah, what? When he calls them Mushabbiha. Aqidatul Jahmiyyah. And this is a sign to know this person is a Jahmi. Naam. Wa alamatul Qadariyyah. The way to recognize a Qadari is what? He calls Ahlul Athar Mujbira. The Qadariyah, they will call Ahlul Sunnah what? They will call the Ahlul Sunnah are the Mujbira. We just spoke about that. Meaning, they're the ones who Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala forces the person into this. Allah forces this person to commit the zina. Wa alamatul murji'ah. And this way to realize the murji'ah is that they call what? They call Ahlul Sunnah what? Mukhalifatan wa naqsaniyah. They call them mukhalifatan and they call them naqsaniyah. Why would they say that? They call them that because mukhalifa means they oppose us, and naqsaniya maybe they call them that because they believe that iman decreases. وعلامة الرافضة أن علامة of the رافضة is تسمية أهل السنة ناصبة. They call أهل السنة what? The ناصبة. The ناصبة are who? The Khawarij who used to call Ali ibn Abi Talib and used to insult him. Who used to fought against Ali ibn Abi Talib. That's what they're trying to say. He then write this down, and it's very important that you remember. There are signs to recognize Ahlul Bid'ah. From them, the first one Abu Hatim mentioned, which is what? Al-waqi'atu fi ahli al-athar. They criticize the people of the text. The second thing that you realize a person in innovation is what? Shiddatu mu'adatim li ahli al-hadith. He has excessive hate for the people of hadith. Huh? And he's silent of who? Wasukutum an ahli al-ghayy wal-batil. And the people of transgression and the people who are the criminals and the wrongdoers, he's silent about them. He won't say nothing about them. As Allah said about the Khawarij, يقتلون أهل الإسلام, they kill the people of Islam, ويدعون أهل الأوثان, and they leave the idol worshippers. That's how the أهل البدع always are. And Imam al-Sabuni said the same in his Aqidah book. And Imam al-Sabuni, he has a book called Aqidah al-Salafi wa Ashab al-Hadith. He said, وعلامة البدع, على أهلها بادية ظاهرة وأظهر آياتهم وعلاماتهم شدة معاداتهم لحملة أخبار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم واحتقارهم لهم وتسمية إياهم حشوية وجهلة وظاهرية ومشبهة اعتقادا منهم في أخبار رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنها بمعزل عن العلم وأن العلم ما يلقيه الشيطان إليهم من نتائج عقولهم الفاسدة ووساوس صدورهم المضلة and etc. You see, and also Sabuni mentions the same, that the sign of the people of innovation is that it's apparent and it's clear their hate for the ones who are carrying the narration of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they belittle them. And you see that sign who today who? The ulama. They're criticizing the ulama. Scholar? Scholar for Allah. Who are they? What do they do? They only know hayd and nifas. Alama min ahla alamati ahli al-bid'ah. You see? The third thing that you are signed for ahli al-bid'ah is what? استعانتهم الولاة والسلاطين بسبب ضعف حجة أهل البدع. One of the evidences that they use is that they use the leaders. What do they use? They use the leaders and they use the people in authority because of their weak proofs. They don't have proofs. They're weak people. They can't argue. They can't author. So they use the leaders against the people of the Sunnah. They do that. and that is what the Mu'tazila did to Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Imam Ahmad was in prison because of the leaders. They went to the leaders, they couldn't speak to him, and so they convinced the leader, and that's how they did it. The fourth one is al-ijtihad wal-ghulu fi al-ibadah. They strive hard, and they go excessive in ibadah. They go excessive. Na'am.
Qawluhu la yalhaqu ahlu sunnati illa ismun wahid.
Illa ismun wahid.
ويستحيل أن تجمعهم هذه الأسماء.
And then he told you, you can call them حشوية, you can call them مشبهة, you can call them ناصبة. Whatever names you give them, none of those names will come with them. The one name that's going to stand for them is what? أهل السنة. That is the only name that they will ever have. They are أهل السنة. They are the people of the Sunnah, and that's the only name that's going to be attached to them. And all of those names can't go with them because they are far from it. They are far from what those names carry. نعم.
قال أبو محمد سمعت أبي وأبا زرعة يأمراني بهجران أهل البدع والزيغ يغلظاني في ذلك أشد التغليظ وينكراني وضع الكتب بغير آثار.
And Abu Muhammad Abd al-Rahman ibn Abi Hatim, he said, I heard my father and I heard Abu Zura'a, both of them ordering the boycotting of the people of innovation. Al-Zaygh, those who have deviated from the right path, boycott them. وَيُغَلِّضَانِ فِي ذَلِكَ And they were very staunch and harsh on that. أَشَدَّ التَّغْلِيظ They were the staunch and hard on that excessively. وَيُنْكِرَانِ And they used to reject وَضْعُ الْكُتُبِ To place a book without ayat and hadith. They used to be very harsh on that. They used to be. And this is an issue which one needs to really understand, which is sitting with the people of innovation. Allah said in the Quran, وَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِ إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا مِثْلَهُمْ Allah said in the ayah, which is an evidence to not sit with the people of innovation, is Allah said in that verse, if you hear Allah's verses being disbelieved in or it being mocked by a group of people, don't sit with those people who are doing that, who are disbelieving in the verses of Allah, who are mocking the religion by innovating and adding to the religion, don't sit with them. فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعْهُمْ Don't sit with them. حَتَّى يَخُوذُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِ Until they repent from their misguidance and that which they are upon. If you do sit with them then, إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِثْلَهُمْ Then you are like them. You are like them. And now, we have these people who are propagating this belief of us and the Rafid that need to work together. We need to unite. Let's put our differences aside. Unity by ummi is necessary, and let's come together. Look at Immatu Salaf, Abi Hatim al-Razi, Abi Zur'at al-Razi. All of them are calling by, and what are they saying? Boycott the people of innovation, and the people whose hearts are deviated from the Haqq. And they were very staunch and hard on this issue, and they used to reject anyone who wrote books without having text and evidences for it. And there are many extensive evidences. People who boycotted the people of innovation. The ayah, the Prophet ﷺ recited the ayah, هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله وما يعلم تأويله إلا الله والراسخون في العلم يقولون آمنا به كل من عند ربنا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب. The Prophet recited that verse to Aisha, and then he said, Aisha, أولئك الذين سمى الله الذين يتبعون, the ones who are following the verses which are ambiguous are the ones who Allah has mentioned to you, Aisha. And those are the ones that have been mentioned. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ سَمَّ اللَّهُ, those who Allah has mentioned them, فَحْذَرُوهُمْ, stay away from them. Don't get close to them. The Prophet is saying this to his own wife, Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها. Stay away from them. Don't get too close to them. They are misguided individuals. Abu Jawza, Abu Jawza, Abu Jawza is the man who said, جَاوَرْتُ بْنَ عَبَّاسٍ إِثْنَتَيْ عَشَرَ سَنَةً. Abu Jawza is the man who said, I was a neighbor of Abdullah ibn Abbas for 12 years. 12 years I was Abdullah ibn Abbas's neighbor. 12 years I was Abdullah ibn Abbas's neighbor. And look what he said about the people of innovation and sitting with them. He said, لَأَنْ يُجَاوِزْنِي قِرَدَةٌ وَخَنَازِيرُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَنْ يُجَاوِرُنِي أَحَدٌ مِّنْهُمْ, يعني أصحاب الأهواء. He said, for a monkey and for a pig to be my neighbor is more beloved to me than a person of innovation, to be my next door neighbor, let alone live with me in the same house or for him and I to have friendship. Imam al-Lalaka'i Abu Qasim Hibatullah al-Lalaka'i narrated that in his Usul al-Itiqad, Ibn Battah in his Kitab al-Ibanat al-Kubra, and other books have also been said. Fudayl ibn al-Iyad, he said, لا تجلسوا مع صاحب بدعة, do not sit with a person of innovation. فَإِنِّي أَخَافُ أَن تَنْزِلَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْلَعْنَةِ, I am scared that while you're sitting with this individual, curses of Allah will come down on you. لعن, لعن means what? الطرد من رحمة الله, Allah's mercy is being distanced from you. Allah's verses, Allah's what? Allah's mercy will be distanced for you. A man entered onto Muhammad ibn Sirin. A man entered onto Muhammad ibn Sirin. And two individuals. There were two men, they entered onto Muhammad ibn Sirin and they were from the Ahlul Ihwa wal Bid'ah, people of innovation, people who follow their whims and desires. فَقَالَ, they both said to them, يَا أَبَا بَكْرٍ, meaning Muhammad ibn Sirin, نُحَدِّثُكَ بِحَدِيثٍ, we want to inform you of a hadith from the Prophet. قَالَ لَا, Imam Muhammad ibn Sirin said no. قَالَ, they both said to him, فَنَقْرُ عَلَيْكَ آيَةً مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, we're going to read on you a verse from Allah's book. قَالَ لَا, he said no. لَتَقُومَانِ عَنِّي, he said, you guys are going to leave and stand up and leave me, أَوْ لَأَقُومَنَّ, or I'm going to leave you guys. فَخَرَجَا, and they both left him. فَقَالَ بَعْضُ الْقَوْمِ, some of the people who were sitting there saw, said to Muhammad ibn Sirin, يَا أَبَا بَكْرٍ, أَوْ أَبَا بَكْرٍ, وَمَا كَانَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ يَقْرَأَ, what is it that you didn't want them to read on you? آيَةٌ مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, why didn't you just let them read the book of Allah on you? قَالَ, he said, إِنِّي خَشِيتُ أَنْ يَقْرَأَ عَلَيَّ آيَةٌ, he said, I was scared that they may recite on me an ayah. فَيُحَرِّفُونَهَا, and they distort it. فَيُقِرُّ ذَلِكَ فِي قَلْبِي, and then that matter sticks to my heart. Who is this? Muhammad ibn Sirin, who's saying about himself, Imam. Muhammad ibn Sirin is an Imam. And then you find a Muslim person who watches an innovator, listens to him, says, no, alhamdulillah, I'm all right. It's very serious. The matter is very, very serious. And now that's what's happening with the da'wah. People who are what? Innovators. Dullal ahlil bid'ah. People of innovation. People are, akhi, leave him alone. Akhi. They defend them. And the religion of Allah, Allah's deen, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is going to be messed up with. And it's going to be distorted. And its meaning and its explanation is going to be played and tampered with. And you're silent. Let it be. Let it take place. No problem. Abdul Razak ibn Hamam al-San'ani, he said, قَالَ لِي إِبْرَاهِيمُ ibn Muhammad ibn Abi Yahya. Ibrahim ibn Muhammad ibn Abi Yahya said to Abdul Razak ibn Hamam, أَرَى الْمُعْتَزِلَةَ عِنْدَكُمْ كَثِيرًا, I see that the Mu'tazila with you guys, in where you're from, there are a lot. He said, yes. وَهُمْ يَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّكَ مِنْهُمْ, and they claim that you're from them. قَالَ, he said, أَفَلَا تَدْخُلُ مَعِي هَذَا الْحَانُوتَ حَتَّى أُكَلِّمَكَ, sorry, Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-San'ani said, Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-San'ani said, and Ibrahim ibn Muhammad ibn Abi Yahya said to me, I see that the Mu'tazila with you guys are a lot? Abdul Razak said, I said, yes, they are a lot. But they claim that you're from them. You, Ibrahim ibn Muhammad ibn Abi Yahya, they say that you're from them. They claim you're part of them. Qala, he said to me, Ibrahim ibn Muhammad ibn Abi Yahya said to me, أَفَلَا تَدْخُلُ مَعِي هَذَا الْحَانُوتَ حَتَّى أُكَلِّمَكَ. Why don't you come and you enter here, the Hanut here with me, so I can talk to you? قلت, I said to him, no. قَالَ لِمَا, he said to me, why? He said, لِأَنَّ الْقَلْبَ ضَعِيفٌ وَالدِّينُ لَيْسَ لِمَنْ غَلَبْ. He said, Abdul Razak ibn Hammam, he said to him, come and enter here with me. Stand here with me in the Hanut and we talk. Abdul Razak said to him, so I could talk to you. Abdul Razak said, no. Why? He said to him. He said, because the heart is weak. Ah. And the matter of the religion, وَالدِّينُ لَيْسَ لِمَنْ غَلَبْ. And the religion isn't the one who overcomes. Ah, I can't sit with you. This is Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-Sam'ani. And he said, you are from the Mu'tazila. And he had the belief of the Mu'tazila. You see, this is how they dealt with them. And Mubashir ibn Ismail al-Halabi, he said, قِيلَ لِلْأَوْزَاعِي, it was said to Imam al-Awza'i, إِنَّ رَجُلًا يَقُولُ, a man says, أَنَا أُجَالِسُ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةُ وَأَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ. Imam al-Awza'i, it was said to him that a man says, I sit with Ahlul Sunnah and I also sit with Ahlul Bid'ah. Al-Imam al-Awza'i, he said, هَذَا رَجُلٌ يُرِيدُ أَن يُسَاوِي بَيْنَ الْحَقِّ وَالْبَاطِلِ. That person is an individual who wants to what? He wants to make it equal, the haq and the batil. Na'am. He wants to make the haq and the batil equal. Na'am. And it's a very dangerous issue that wallahi, there is ghulu and there is tafrid. There's ifrad and tafrid. There is ifrad and tafrid. People who are Ahlul Sunnah, who aqeedah are correct, their manhaj is right, there are people who literally label those people Ahlul Bid'ah. You see? And they go against what? The other evidences that prove that, ya ayyuhal qawm, oh people, this person is Ahlul Sunnah. What have you got against him? There's a ghulu. There's an extreme that way. And there is another extreme which is, where the person is clearly Ahlul Bid'ah. He's from the innovators now. Of the maqalat, of the statements that he said, And till now, you still defend him. You are what? You're defending him. وَكِلَ الطَّرَفَيْنِ مَذْمُونَ. Both parties are blameworthy. And both parties are not good. Which is to criticize a person from something he isn't. And also, a person who's an innovator, you're still trying to what? Listen to his videos, tapes. Na'am. People who are fighting against the sunnah, they are fighting against Allah's religion, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You still say, I will listen and I will benefit from it. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. نَعَمْ.
قَوْلُهُ وَيَنْهَيَانِ عَنْ مُجَالَسَةِ أَهْلِ الْكَلَامِ وَالنَّذْرِ فِي كُتُبِ الْمُتَكَلِّمِينَ وَيَقُولَانِ لَا يُفْلِحُ صَاحِبُ كَلَامٍ أَبَدًا.
And they both used to prohibit in sitting with the people of innovation. Don't sit with them, Ahlul Kalam. No, don't sit with them. Because Ahlul Bid'ah. وَالنَّذْرِ فِي كُتُبِ الْمُتَكَلِّمِينَ. And do not look at the books of the people of innovation, Ahlul Kalam. وَيَقُولَانِ أَنْ إِمَابُ زُرْعَى أَنْ أَبِي حَاتِمُ will both say لَا يُفْلِحُ صَاحِبُ كَلَامٍ أَبَدًا. A person who is from the Ahlul Kalam will never find prosperity and success. That's the Aqidah Ahli Sunnah. Imam Shafi'i used to say, the person who's Ahlul Kalam, Imam Shafi'i used to say this, that anybody who's Ahlul Kalam or who goes towards Ahlul Kalam, Imam Shafi'i used to say, he should be taken and he should be placed on a donkey and he should be taken to the market. And he should be whipped with what? He should be whipped with branches. He should be whipped. And Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah, he said, وَعَلَمْنَوْ أَنَّهَا لَمْ تَكُنْ الزَّنْدَقَةُ وَلَا كُفْرٌ وَلَا شُكُوكٌ وَلَا بِدْعَةٌ وَلَا ضَلَالَةٌ وَلَا حَيْرَةٌ فِي الدِّينِ إِلَّا مِنْ أَمِنَ الْكَلَامِ. There is no zandaqa. Zandaqa. And there's no kufr. And there is no doubt. And there's no bid'ah. And there's no misguidance. And there's no confusion in this religion except it came from ilm al-kalam. وَأَهْلُ الْكَلَامِ وَالْجَدَلِ وَالْمِرَاءِ وَالْخُصُومَةِ وَالْعُجْبِ. The people of kalam, the people of arguments and debate, their religion is always أَجْدَالًا and خُصُومَاتًا. Arguments all day. And عُجْب, fascinated. وَكَيْفَ يَجْتَرِئُ الرَّجُلُ عَلَى الْمِرَاءِ وَالْخُصُومَةِ وَالْجِدَالِ. How can somebody have the audacity to go towards argumenting and debating and all of this? وَاللَّهُ تَعَالَى يَقُولُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ says in the Quran, مَا يُجَادِلُ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ. No one argues in the book of Allah, in the verses of Allah, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا except the disbelievers. فَعَلَيْكَ بِالتَّسْلِيمِ. Don't argue, surrender. Surrender to the text. عليك بالتسليم والرضا بالآثار. Surrender. Give yourself in to the text. والكفية. And withhold. والسكوت. Withhold from arguing. Withhold in indulging into views of philosophy and etc. And be silent of this. Ahlul Kalam, what do? All they do is they build something and they break it. They build it and they break it. And the Prophet ﷺ told us in the hadith, أَبْغَضُ الرِّجَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَلَدُّ الْخَصْمِ. The people that are most hated to Allah are the ones who are argumentative. They're the most hated people to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a person stays away from it. He doesn't make his religion عُرْضَةٌ لِلْنِقَاشِ, placing your religion on the table for everybody to discuss it with you. Establish what's upon your haqq and establish what is for you, but move on. Making your religion argument and debate isn't a religious way a person goes by. And no doubt all of these issues, they have istithna'at, they have exceptions, halat, situations when a person is allowed to argue and is allowed to debate. Al-Sunnah have also spoken about that, but we will leave that for other books of aqaid which we're going to do. We have finished the kitab, and that is all, that is it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.